Mr. Hamilton?
Yes, Alexander.
G'day, I'm Johnny Topper. I'm here to pick you up and take you to the Palace Hotel. 30 Cadex waiting there for you with my father.
Oh, yes.
Is this your first time in Kalgoorlie?
Yes.
I was brought up here in the Nickelberg. You should have seen it then. Full of prospectors, journos, gamblers, crooks. They all crowded in to get on the bandwagon. Well, it's quieter these days.
Ferdy Kadek says there's a new move coming.
Well, people like Kadek have to believe that. It's what keeps this place going.
You work for...
No. I'm a geologist. I graduated from the School of Mines last year.
Really?
Well, nothing compared to your degrees. Well, that's why I wanted to meet you.
Johnny, do you know where I can find Peterson Geophysics?
Yeah, it's in Maritana Street.
I'd like to stop off there. I've got a few samples I'd like tested.
Well, no problem. It's just around the corner. No, that's Peterson's in there.
Come along.
Hamilton doing at Bull Rock?
Visiting friends, the Carriages. And I suspect he was taking a look over their mine, Golden Soak.
That old thing. Been derelict for years. He'd have to be hard up.
He is.
Still, you never know. Plenty of things have happened.
The gold content looks good.
I thought over 6 ounces.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe. We do some tests, yeah? And the content of the antimony requires special analysis.
How soon can you get it out?
Day after tomorrow.
I'd appreciate that.
And now, you go to work for Kadek and Chris Galton, yeah? How do I know? In this town, everybody knows everything. You be careful.
Why do you say that?
They got a mine called Black Ridge over at Orabanda. I do an analysis for them. On the samples they bring.
But you're not happy with them.
Surface dirt. Just remember what I told you. Surface dirt. I say no more. Ah, Johnny. You're selling this Alec fella to look out for your old man and Kadek?
Yeah, I heard you, Pete.
Johnny and me, we're old friends. No secrets. Okay. You come back day after tomorrow.
Alec, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to overhear. It was hot outside.
Do you know anything about this Kadek deal?
No. Only if my father's involved, we'll take notice of what he said. Watch out.
Right. The plane landed half an hour ago.
Maybe your boy forgot to pick him up.
Not a chance. The opportunity to meet a real mining man with real degrees? Johnny wouldn't pass up something like that. Where the hell have you been?
Alec, we thought you got lost.
Ready?
This is Chris Culpin.
How are you? What happened?
My fault. My first time in Kalgoorlie here, I asked Johnny to show me the town.
What, you've been sightseeing? And we've been hanging around here?
Afraid so. Thanks for the tour, Johnny.
It's a pleasure.
Well, the main thing is that you're here. Let's go up to my room and we'll put you in the picture. Here we are, Orabanda. It's about 60 kilometers. Chris was out there looking up an old mine when he discovered traces of nickel.
We've already paid a square mile of it.
Tomorrow, we've got the managing director of Lawn Minerals flying in from Sydney. That's where you come in.
Oh.
He's interested, but he needs a bit of encouragement. Let's say, if he thought one of the big English mining groups were after this.
I'm to make him believe, sir.
You ought to be there, that's all. I'll do whatever talking is needed.
I don't think I like the sound of it, Fred.
Oh, you don't, eh?
Just a minute. What's your problem, Alec? It's genuine. It's a new nickel strike. And that's what this place badly needs right now.
Of course it's genuine. Read the analysis report. Even Peterson had to agree it was a high nickel content.
The samples he tested, were they just surface dead?
That's right.
Well, I'd have to make some tests of my own.
Why?
Well, to find out what's below the surface.
This place calling me a crook, Ferdy.
Hang on, Chris. Leave us alone, will you?
I don't think we want this joker, Ferdy.
Just shut up and get out, Chris. You heard me.
Johnny?
You mustn't mind Chris. He's edgy about this one. He hasn't had a lot of luck since things went sour after the boom. I nearly forgot. You can cash this check at the bank next door.
What's this?
Your airfare and expenses. Come on, take it. I'll bet you haven't much more than 20 bucks left.
$1,000.
Expenses plus retainer.
Now hang on, Ferdy.
And after tomorrow, there'll be another 2,000. Don't tell me you can't use it.
Of course I can, but... Well, this stinks, and you know it.
Nevertheless, you're going to cooperate. Or I cable the British police that you're alive and well and living in Australia. I'm sorry, Alec. I wanted to keep it friendly, but... This is for high stakes, and I can't afford your moral attitudes. There's
Ferdy!
You're right on time. Meet Chris Culpin.
Good to meet you, Mr. Freeman.
And this is Alec Hamilton.
Alec?
You've heard of the English mining consultants Travis Parks and Pierce. Alec is one of their top men.
Don't tell me the big boys are interested in this mine, too.
He's reporting on prospects for a group in England.
Oh, that's so. I might have to move quickly, then.
Word's got around, I'm afraid. Then we're on a winner.
This way, Mr. Freeman.
What the hell are you playing at?
Nobody out here is going to question your status.
You know damn well I haven't worked with that firm for over 2 years.
Alec... Do you want to spend the next few years in jail? Thanks.
What's going on?
I think he's hooked. He wants to talk to Alec.
Hell, that's taking a risk.
I wouldn't say so.
Well, I've read those analysis reports. What's your opinion? Perhaps I don't have to tell you I'm an accountant, not a mining expert. I'd appreciate your view.
I don't think I can give you an opinion.
Why not? You're a geologist.
I haven't done any geochemical tests. There's nickel there, but I can't tell you how deep without drilling.
You're playing it pretty cagey, Alec. I'm not suggesting you give your advice for free. I want a geological report to present to my board. We need a project like this.
It'll push our shares in the market, and a report from someone of your standing would do it.
You're going to buy the mine?
Unless you say categorically that I shouldn't.
I can't say that.
So write a report, and that'll clinch it. And I'll write a check.
That's what you want.
Great. Great. It's perfect. Here, Alec. I'll see Les Freeman gets it. There's your $2,000 in cash.
And a check from Freeman. You'll do better than me, and I've done all the work.
Do yourself some good, Alec. Buy those shares. They'll start climbing when this news gets out.
You're all over the bar. Phones will be running hot, just like the old days.
I'm sorry, Alec. I can't take you to dinner tonight. I've got something waiting for me back in Perth.
How was Alec?
Angry when I last saw him.
At anyone in particular?
At the world. And me in particular.
I suppose you blackmailed him.
My dear Rosa.
Yes, you blackmailed him.
I was going, Freeman needed a project to put his company in the news. So I cut your husband in for some loose change.
Dear generous Ferdy. You're a real bastard, aren't you?
If it appeals to you.
Oh, it does. I'm afraid it always did, that kind of thing.
I bought you a present.
Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Some shares. There's Freeman's company.
Thank you.
I bought you 5,000.
How nice. And what return do you expect on your investment?
No strings.
Oh, come on, Ferdy. We both know you better than that.
All right, you're short of money. This makes you independent for a while.
Or dependent on you.
At least you can stay in Perth. No need to go back to Alec.
The analysis seems good. Gold, 7.25 ounces average. You want to see? But the antimony, not so good. More variable.
But encouraging.
So you go back there, test drill, huh?
I think so.
Yeah. Good luck, Alex. Come in any time you're in town.
Thanks, Pete.
Do some research. What have you got in the mine up in the Pilbara? It's called the Golden Soap.
Dad!
Oh, that's a nice welcome.
There's a telegram from Alec. He's coming back.
Does he say why?
Well, all he says is, must talk with you and your father, Sir Alec.
Can I talk to you?
Come in.
going north, aren't you? Golden Soak?
Yes.
Can I come along?
Can't pay you.
No pay? Well, in fact, I'd save you money. I've got the Land Rover. I just want to do a survey with someone of your experience. Look, if it's not with you, I'll go up to the Territory and get a job with one of the uranium mines.
A couple of conditions. I pay the expenses and lease the truck. We'll leave at daybreak in the morning.
Going chasing gold mines, are you?
What do you want?
You'd ditch me, would you? Go chasing off with some bloody pommy. After all I've done for you. Giving you all the things I never had.
What happened to your face?
I had a fall.
Janet!
Thank God I found you.
What the devil are you doing here?
Dad, come back with me, please. You've been here all night. I've been worried out of my mind.
There's no need to.
Look. Whatever it is, why can't you wait for Alec?
I know what I'm doing.
Then tell me!
I'll show you the way back. I want you to go home and stay there.
Desert.
Ever hear of Lake Disappointment?
And a man called McElroy?
No, I don't think so. Come and have some tucker. Well, who was he? This McElroy?
Ah, it's not important. Pretty good at all this?
My father taught me. When I was a kid, we used to go on hunting trips for minerals. Like other kids taking to the beach for picnics. I'm so scared of him, Alec. That's the truth. He did this.
I wondered.
He made me tell him about Peterson's tests. I'm sorry.
How much he can do?
I don't know. He smells money. He's been without it for so long.
I think I might be onto something. Golden soap. Something no one else knows.
But I told you... What? Yes. Yes, I see. You'd better come to Perth. Call me here. I may not be in the office tomorrow. I'm taking a few days off. Yes, I'll pay expenses. Get here as soon as you can. Okay, Chris. Goodbye.
Was that about Alec?
Yes. He's gone back to Jarabinda.
Because of the mine?
Looks like it.
So there's something in it after all?
Not for Alec. For me. And you, maybe.
Are you married?
Yeah.
Where's your wife?
England.
You go back there one day, will you?
No, go to sleep. I'll wake you around about 3.
Oh, I can't stop thinking about Jarabinda. What happens when we get there?
God knows.
Oh, Garrity, what's he like?
Tough.
And the girl, Janet?
Aren't you tired?
She not?
Yes, go to sleep.
Thank you. Janet! Ed!
Thought they were expecting you. Say, I came back, did you?
What the hell do you want here, Westrop?
Been collecting samples, haven't you? How'd they turn out?
It's my business. No need for the gun.
You bloody idiot! I got nothing against you, Hamilton. I don't want you following me, that's all. Keep out of it, mate. I got Garrity to deal with. I don't need you as well.
What are you after, Westrop?
The truth. And half this place, it belongs to me.
What?
Pat McElroy's share. He was a partner here. He was also my uncle.
Had to be some angle. That was 30 years ago.
So what? I'm still entitled. Garrity won't make a deal. I've been through his papers, there's no proof, nothing. So I'll do it my way.
You're going out to the mine?
Keep out of it. It's between me and him.
Bit of Ed's there.
There's another entrance. Wally knows it.
Don't be crazy, most of that mine's unsafe. What do you hope to find?
Your pal knows. I told him once.
Said he's looking for McElroy. You're wrong. McElroy left Nulligan and headed out to the Gibson Desert. Must have found his truck there.
But not his body. Suppose he never went into the Gibson.
That's just an old rumor.
No, I got proof. He came here, he was killed here. That's the answer. It has to be.
Okay, Phil.
Nice jaggers, you know, mate.
Garrity truck. Maybe we wait until he goes.
We'll use the other entrance.
Why, suddenly, after all this time?
I don't know.
Who is it?
Prophecy. God bless you.
Oh, good, lovey. That's what I call a welcome.
Where's Janet? Never mind. Hop on the back, Johnny. Come on, let's go.
No, I only just got here.
Westrop's at the mine.
So's it. Janet called this morning. She was a bit of a state. Had to look after the cattle, because Ed's been down his mine the past day or two. I was worried, so I came over.
Thank God you did.
Good to see you. Your mate all right in the back?
Well, he's still there, just...
Alan!
Westrop told you.
Slow down a bit, will you? Yes, he told me. McElroy's nephew.
He spilled it in the bar last night. Had a few drinks to board.
Did he say why he suddenly turned up?
He only heard about McElroy a month or two ago. His mother died, and he found a letter McElroy had written to him before he went out to the Gibson looking for his Copper Mountain. Said he was coming back to Jarrabinda first to settle things with Ed Garrity. Yeah, makes you wonder. But at least he's still with us.
Prophecy, stop.
What is it?
Thunder?
No cloud.
How far's that mine?
About half a mile.
Hang on, Johnny.
You're like hell.
Stay back. We'll check the entrance.
Well, there's no hope.
We gotta find out.
The main shaft must have collapsed. Couldn't be anyone alive. Not after that.
There's another entrance if we can find it.
Come on, no one in their right mind's going to go down there now.
Alec! Over here!
Come from? Are you here, Owen?
We just arrived. We saw it. Thank God you were out.
I told you. It's finished.
Ed, Westrop may be down there. Westrop. You know who I mean. Wally and he said there's another entrance.
No. No. No.
Another entrance, Ed.
Do you know where it is? Can you show us? Johnny, get the gear out of Prophecy's ute.
To the second level. I'm coming with you.
No, you're not.
Let me help you, Alec.
You stay with me, Ed. Johnny will go.
Yeah.
It's only a pilot probe. Missed on my own. Thank you.
want a rest in the truck?
No.
It was nobody's fault, Ed. Did you know Westrop was McElroy's nephew?
Oh, yes, I know. Why couldn't he let it rest instead of digging up old rumors?
I think I ought to tell you. He was shouting it in the bar at Nullagine that he had proof, some letter.
Saying what?
That McElroy came here before he disappeared in the Gibson Desert.
Yes, that's right. He did.
Go and get some fresh air, Ed.
Yes, I think I...
Wally! Easy, mate. No one's going to hurt you. Now, just tell us what happened. Where's Westrop?
Prophecy's taken Wally back to town. And that boy, Johnny, went with them. The police will be here in the morning. And then you can... Don't you want this? It's cold. I'll make you another. Dad. Oh, Dad, it was an accident. It just collapsed. And you always said it was unsafe. Prophecy said you risked your life.
Prophecy talks too much.
I love you. I've always loved you.
Weak?
Oh, no. Since I went to England, and Rosa made me feel like a 20-year-old hick. You made me feel very grown up.
Now you are. Grown up enough to hear what I have to tell you.
Is it nice?
Not very.
Well, then are you sure you want to tell me?
I have to. I'm a coward.
I don't believe that. Prophecy said, and Johnny, no one else would have gone in there.
I'm talking about moral cowardice. Running away from failure. I didn't just leave England. I escaped. From a fraud charge.
Listen to me, Alec.
Then in Kalgoorlie, I let myself be blackmailed. I'm involved in a swindle.
Listen, will you? I don't care. I don't care what you've done. You're here, aren't you? You're staying here.
I want to.
Then that's all that matters.
There's something else.
Tell me tomorrow.
I'll send Tom out for the cattle. They'll be at the mine soon. The sergeant and his party.
Yes. I'll run you out.
It will be all right, won't it? It collapsed. Dad said it was unsafe. And at the inquest, well, you're a mining expert. You can tell him.
I can't.
What?
It didn't just collapse.
Alec.
That's what I was trying to tell you last night.
But I don't understand. It caved in. Why, you saw it. Of course it did. Dad was lucky to get out alive.
He wasn't in there, Jan.
Oh, don't be ridiculous.
Let him say it.
You were never in there. There was no way you could have got out. No caving like that ever happened of its own accord. Did you know Westrop was down there?
No. I swear I didn't.
Will one of you tell me what in God's name you're talking about?
He put gelignite charges in there. Detonated them from the outside. That's what made the mine collapse. And killed Westrop.